Coming up on UPC, Groundhog's Day is today. Where's the shadow?
I will have information on football scholarships today in sports.
And Club Picture Day is tomorrow. We have the scoop on where to get the passes. All this and much more is coming up on UPC, and it starts right now.
Welcome to the Monday, February 2nd edition of the UPC Morning Show. I'm Diane Johnson.
And I'm Amy Butler. Colorado State will have a showcase January 30th, February 16th, 27th, March 20th, and April 25th. Attendance is limited, so please pre-register at least 2 weeks in advance. For more information, please contact the Office of Admissions at 970-491-6909. A reminder to all Crop Step students, your monthly meeting will be Friday the 6th from 1 to 2 upstairs in the auditorium. A representative from FAMU will be the guest speaker.
Seniors, Homeroom Wednesday is your opportunity to learn about ordering graduation gowns and applying for graduation. Forms for both will be explained and made available during this important homeroom. The University of Florida will have a representative here February 10th from 8:30 to 2. They'll be prepared to make a decision on your admittance to UCF on the same day. If you would like an interview with your admissions counselor, please see Ms. Gonza in guidance for your individual appointment time by Friday, February 6th.
There is an SAT prep course available at Countryside. Math courses will be held February 3rd through March 24th on Tuesdays from 2:30 to 4:30 with Ms. Brown instructing. The English courses will be conducted by Ms. Sorello Donnell February 5th through March 26th at 2:30 to 4:30 on Thursdays. Each course is $25 to take. For registration or more information, please call 341-4441 or 341-4451. Bethany College will have the Calon Leadership Scholarship Program Saturday, March 14th at 9 a.m. This is for a $5,000 renewable scholarship. For more information, call 1-800-922-7611.
There's a brief SGA meeting after school today to get your passes for the club picture. Have you ever wondered about teen criminals? Well, here's Amy to tell you more.
Saved a life from me.
Teen crime is on the rise, but what is the driving force behind their actions?
When I got jumped by a certain group of kids for no reason.
I had fun while I was doing it, but then I still got to pay the consequences, so I regret it a lot.
I didn't think it was wrong, I was just having fun.
Hanging around the wrong people, when they wanted stuff, I'd go get it or something.
Some of them don't have parent support. Some of it's peer pressure. They want to fit in. They want to belong to something.
In the car, that was just for fun. We wanted to get girls with the car and stuff.
After enduring the consequences of their actions, what do they hope that their future holds in store?
I think the boys really struggle with what they know they really want to do in life. They have hopes, they have dreams, they have goals and desires. Opposed to what's reality for them.
I feel when I get out, you know, at least if I'm gonna make a mistake, you know, I ain't gonna go ahead and say, well, screw it, I already made one mistake, might as well make as many mistakes.
I'm gonna try to stop smoking weed. That's the only drug I used to do. But I'm gonna try to stop, you know what I'm saying? I am gonna stop, really. But I'm gonna try to get a job.
I wanna go into some kind of GED program, mm-hmm. Then go into the, try to get a job. I don't know if I'll be able to, though.
I don't want to go back to school and play football really bad.
As much as these juvenile offenders would like to see their lives change, statistics show one out of every three will recommit at some point in their lifetime. Amy Butler, Fox 13 Magazine.
Thanks, Amy. I'll try to stay out of trouble. The University of Florida College of Engineering is hosting an information sessions and laboratory tours for prospective students all 9th through 12th grade students and their parents are welcome to attend. The Friday session is being held February 6th, and the last one is May 1st. To make reservations, see Ms. Gunthery.
There will be a mandatory multicultural committee meeting on Tuesday, February 3rd, that's tomorrow, at 205 in room A5. All members should attend. We will be planning for the peace conference. All Earth Effects members, the group picture is Wednesday morning at 9 a.m. If you want to be in the picture, you must drop by Ms. Kernut's room in D7 to pick up your pass.
All youth and government members, there will be a meeting today, Monday, February 2nd, at 210 in room D2. All drama club members, our club pictures will be on Wednesday, February 4th, during fourth period. Same as Dracus, wore a pass.
Marine Biology Club, pick up calendars in F5. The club yearbook picture will be taken on Wednesday at 8:10. That's during first period in the auditorium. Your first period teachers will have a list with your names on it. Our February meeting will be Thursday the 5th in E2. Chad Ivan will talk about our scuba certification, and cookies and punch will be served. There will be a meeting of the prom committee Thursday, February 5th, right after school in Mr. Kell's room, F1. We will be meeting with our photographer. All committee members should make plans to attend. Also, prom committee members should see Ms. Kell after school today or tomorrow to pick up a pass for the yearbook picture scheduled for Wednesday at 7:55 a.m. And here with an interview with Jeff Petty is Alfredo Sports.
I'm Alfredo Muente with UPC Sports. All senior football players need to see Coach Newberry in room E6 today concerning tryouts for football scholarships. And right now, to tell us a little bit about Friday night's game and a preview of tonight's big matchup against CCC is captain of the boys soccer team, Jeff Petty, who had a good performance on Friday night, scoring 4 goals in a 9-0 win against Dunedin. How are you doing today, Jeff?
All right, how about you?
Okay, I'm doing well. Tell us a little bit about how the team's doing right now.
We're doing really well. We got everyone back. Our record's 10-3-1, and we're looking really strong right now.
All right, and tell us about the big game and the rivalry with CCC.
Well, CCC has always been our longtime rival. They were ranked 8th in the nation last year, and we're 8th in the state this year, so it's going to be a real good game.
Good luck on the game, and once again, congratulations on the great performance on Friday. And also yesterday was the Pro Bowl in Honolulu, Hawaii. The AFC defeated the NFC of the NFL by a score of 29-24. The MVP of the game was quarterback Warren Moon. And the Tampa Bay Lightning, once again, they lose to the Florida Panthers by a shutout score of 2-0 on Saturday. The Lightning are winless in their last 13 games. They fall to 9 wins, 35 losses, and 8 ties. And tonight, the Lightning will try to get their 10th win of the year as they take on the Buffalo Sabres. And that is all today in sports. Now back to Amy and Diane.
Thank you so much, Alfredo. And we have a birthday announcement today.
And we have a happy birthday to James Zervios from me and all the rest of the UPC crew.
And we mentioned earlier that it is Groundhog's Day today, but unfortunately the sun is not shining, so most of them, I believe, are indoors. Thanks, guys. And we leave you with a scene of Little Shop of Horrors. Bye.